So The Unreasonable Man is a documentary about a man that I probably the mo my most admired man that is currently living or alive, 'cause most of my heroes or the men I really really admire, they're pretty much all dead except for very few. Cornel West is still alive, Spike Lee is still alive. What else? Who else is still alive that I really really admire? That's all I could think of right now, but I mean, most of the people that I really, really admire, they're all dead. You know, Gandhi, dead. Malcolm X, dead. John Brown, dead. Long time ago, you know. Abraham Lincoln, or fictional, Sam Damon from Once an Eagle, you know, like he's just like, if I had a role model, he would probably be it, you know. So I mean, Ralph Nader is still alive, and he's the man that I like have the utmost high respect for, which might be why I really like this documentary much so much, because of my biased view of loving Ralph Nader so much. I mean, if he runs for president, and and if I was a U.S. citizen, because I'm not, I'm a resident alien, if I was, that would still be the person I'll vote for. I mean, I love Obama and all, but you know, Nader is not a compromiser, and Nader and Obama is, and that's one thing I really don't like about Obama. But in any case, you know, it's interesting. The documentary is kind of split into two eras. You know, the era before Nader ran for presidency, and the era, you know, during and after. And you know, you could see that most people don't know about Nader, and if they do, then they bitched about, you know, how, well, of course, Republicans like him because, you know, they think he actually affected, you know, Bush being elected. And Democrats hate him because they think he's the reason why Bush got elected. So it splits off into that discussion into the middle of the documentary, which, you know, I think it's what people know Nader for, that in fact that he ran for presidency like twice or thrice and affected, you know, and got Bush into the office, which is totally, I actually don't think that's true at all. You know, I think if you're gonna blame Nader for Bush's presidency, that's the wrong person to blame, a wrong thing to blame. The thing to blame is the American political system. Why not blame that? You know, we still have the Electoral College, which is what makes popular vote impossible, and we still have, it's just a ridiculous system where Republicans, Democrats, and the two parties are actually so alike. They're so alike in so many different important issues. Especially the ones dealing with corporate America. You know, they're so alike in that nature that people fighting for, oh my God, you know, I mean, people arguing for what Democrats are the lesser evil, or that, you know, Republicans are more of fiscal responsibility, and, you know, I mean, those are fine arguments and all, but it's just the two-party system has made it so that either party, you elect either party, and you're still screwed. You know, and it's not the presidential party doesn't control things. It's actually the Congress and, you know, the Supreme Court that kind of decides what's going on with the country. The executive branch has its powers, too much powers in kind of the control and monitoring and war making and in the empire building and in the corporatism that goes on around. They have a lot of powers in that, and a lot of control in that. But as far as actual like policies in the country, you know, and I don't know why I'm going into a political debate with when talking about this movie. That's not what I wanted to really talk about. I just wanted to talk, you know, about the different things that Nader really has stood for in this country, and that the fact that not a lot of people are aware of where we went and where we're going, with this nation, you know, and let's just forget about Nader being, you know, running for presidency and all that. I mean, that's an important issue, and I think one thing that Nader kind of realized is to turn his consumer anger, his consumer poli you know, consumer kind of advocacy is the right word, into some kind of a political energy to actually make different kind of changes, which I think is fine too. He's been always been a very grassroots kind of guy, very advocacy related, very consumer focused. So that's always been one thing. People kind of treat him as like the tree hugger because he once ran for the Green Party, but that's really not what Nader has been about. And there's also so many different aspects of Nader that I think is really interesting. A lot of his opponents are actually ex-Nader. You know, the the consumer advocacy group. I forgot the name of it. God, but it has Nader's name in it as like the co-founder or the CEO. And a lot of people are like, we don't want Nader's name on there. We don't know why it's still on there. And a lot of ex-Nader fans, the Nader Raiders, the ex-Nader Raiders, they fall out from him. In a way, that is because Nader has this egotistical nature about him that, whoever is just, follower or supporter, he really wants them to just stick to him and follow him and not go into their own independent path. I think that's one kind of thing that really, created a lot of strife and a lot of controversy and a lot of kind of, not necessarily debate, but separation and a lot of stuff like that. So that was really interesting to see, although in a way, Nader doesn't back down. He doesn't compromise. That's one of his main strength and one of his main weaknesses because, I mean, perhaps he's too strong, he's too hard-headed, and that's why he's not able to actually have as much charisma as someone like Obama would because he appeals to both sides all the time. Nader wouldn't do that. He wouldn't appeal to both sides all the time. He doesn't play politics. He plays what he thinks it would be, a better world. And in a way, Nader's contributions, especially to America, if not the world, are amazing. We if you credit, I mean, at the last part of the video was when the guy kind of talks about if Nader's contributions had credits all over the world, then we would see Nader's name in pretty much everywhere we walk. We would look up at the sky and see Nader for providing clean air. We would look at this bottle right here and see this nutritional facts, Nader. He was the one that advocated for that. Seatbelts, Nader. There's so many different consumer advocated stuff and so many different safety features, so many different environmental stuff, so many different, all these things that make us have healthier, better quality of life. Nader was very responsible for. And I think that's one thing that I really admire about him. He doesn't sleep. He's been single and he's like, what, 86? Has had no wife, and he said that he has no time for relationships because all he is about is work. He's practically a workaholic. And that's just something crazy. He's had no actual personal life. And unlike some presidents like Bill Clinton and some governors, he's had no political scandals because he actually doesn't have any. He's a workaholic. That's just so much interesting thing to talk about. Not to say that he's not a fun guy. And one of the parts of the documentary actually explores his comical side, his humor, how he can impersonate different people in such a humorous way. He's very charming in a way. He has his own sort of charisma. Not the sort of like a all-encompassing charisma like Obama would have, and not the down-to-earth style that I guess President Bush had, but he definitely has that charming sense. And I think if perhaps America allowed for independent parties to run, and if the political system was a little different, was more democratic actually, because America is not a democratic system, a guy like Nader would have a chance. And if that's the case, I mean, I think we could see a lot of change in this nation. Not to say that one president has so much power to change everything, I mean, we could see Obama trying so much, and I respect him for that. But this nation isn't a one-person thing, And so, even if Nader, perhaps, like, it would be like my biggest wish, perhaps. I mean, it'd be too late now because he's so old. But even if Nader got elected as president, I don't think too much would change with the na with how the nation went. But it's still, I think democracy is important. And what Nader really proves to me and shows to everyone is that America is not a democracy. And that's just important thing to consider. I really, hope to read more of Nader's works, more about Nader, more, and probably I should read more of the opposing side as well, those who hate Nader. And of course, I will never agree with the arguments brought up by like the extreme the Democrat liberals who think Nader is responsible for Bush's election. If you go through the logic of that, it just doesn't make any sense why that is. More Republicans voted for Nader than Democrats. That's just one fact to consider. But Anyway, so that was probably my take on the documentary. Really, really interesting documentary. Just to get a quick glimpse of what Nader is like, I actually recommend digging deeper into who Nader is and what he has done if you're interested. But if you just want a quick glimpse, just a 2-hour, just brief overview of that, I think this documentary is a really great source to turn into as well.